According to the Uganda Women Parliamentary Association, WOPA, maternal mortality death rates in Uganda have increased to 336 maternal deaths per 100,000 live births. They attributed it to government's omission to adequately provide basic maternal health care services in public health facilities, which violates the right to health.
Committed itself to providing health care. And right honourable speaker, there is also a constitutional court ruling. And this is a landmark ruling. I think it was constitutional, it was in August of 2021, where some concerned citizens with Sehud went to court, and court made a ruling directing the government to increase health sector funding to equip clinics and hospitals with health workers and commodities to save the lives of pregnant women.
While presenting the petition to Parliament today, Sarah Opendi, the UWOPA chairperson, disclosed that some medical workers are fond of forcing women to go for cesarean section when they can afford natural birth because of commercial gains.
Speaker, we have also seen an increase, there has been an increase deliberately of these cesarean sections. Mothers used to give birth normally, and the cesarean section was a last option if the mother has obstructed labor or is unable to really just push the child naturally. But now it is business.
Opendi's revelation was confirmed by several other legislators who confessed that surgical births are on the rise in their constituencies because pregnant mothers are not given a chance to deliver naturally by medical workers who want to make money out of them.
It brings me to think why they should say increase salary for these medical workers, yet they are still extorting money from the poor people.
And whereby every pregnant woman who goes to give birth is put on cesarean. It wasn't like that before. Women were given chances to either push. When you fail, at least you go into a cesarean process. But these days, it's as if whoever gets pregnant will be unable to produce. We've looked at it as if it's like the way of getting more money from our women.
Legislators decried the arrogance of health workers in maternal wards and called for setting up dedicated hotlines where women in labor can report all cases of corruption and negligence at health facilities.
Where they were demanding for 500,000 to save in order to help her give birth. This is just about a week ago, right honorable speaker. Unfortunately, we lost this mother in the hospitals because health workers demand for money. Put the money there, 500,000, you don't have it, your patient will die. So right honorable speaker, with a dedicated hotline, would be able to sort out this corruption in the health facilities. Save the mother first.
Dead. Mitoma Health Center 4, and it was a weekend. I was surprised to find women lining up to go and give birth. There was only one midwife, the rest were on a weekend. And this is very unfortunate because with delivery, it can't wait that this is Monday, I wait until maybe Saturday.
The debate shifted from the Minister of Health, and MPs piled pressure on government to consider adequate budgeting for the health sector. Lawmakers tasked government to equip health centers with basic supplies.
Issues of maternal health all rotate on the budget. I think it was in 2001 when they made all health centers not operational. There are some areas where you find it is so hard to move from a parish, to move from the village to health center 3s. So I think government should make an effort to make health center 2s operational, at least for antenatal, postnatal, and immunization.
Parliament adopted the petition with a strong call to the Minister of Health to fix gaps in the maternal health services. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.